Internet. My name is Ayla Tesler-Mabe. Today, I'm going to walk you through my process learning a song on the spot to hopefully give you some ideas around how you could build this skill yourself. Because for better or for worse, I've been put in this situation many times in my life, and I've found a bit of a process that works for me, but of course it depends on the song. Either way, I just hope this gives you some ideas around how you can do this yourself. So, I was challenged to learn to Fly by the Foo Fighters. The Foo Fighters.
Ladies and gentlemen, Foo Fighters.
I've heard this song many times in my life. It's on, I think, the Rock Band 1 soundtrack. It's where I first heard it. So, I've heard it a bunch of times, but I've never tried playing it. And the first step whenever I try to learn a song is to listen to it as much as possible. So before you even sit down to learn a song, in an ideal situation, I'd recommend you sit down to listen to it, or walk around and listen to it, or wherever you like listening to music, as much as possible, because a lot of learning music comes down to knowing a piece of music really well. But let's say you're on a time crunch, you don't have the chance to do that. Let's just dive in right now. We're gonna go piece by piece. So I'm just gonna hit play, and let's just spend a bit of time listening to the song, and let's just see what we hear. Oh, it's Jack Black. Okay, so I've scrubbed to the part of the video where the song starts. Let's hit play. Okay, so the video's so good. So, first thing I heard, it opened with some kind of cool slide down. We'll listen again to see if we can find the exact fret they were sliding down from. But so far, I was hearing some drums, bass, and a rhythm and lead guitar part. So typically, when I'm learning a song, I do really like using earbuds because it can be so helpful to listen with just the left ear and then just the right ear, because sometimes you'll hear certain parts are panned more to one side or the other, and it can be really nice to isolate them this way. But hey, it's okay. For this, we're just gonna stick with my laptop speakers. No big deal. But first step, I wanna see if we can hear where that slide down starts from. So I'm actually gonna put this in 0.5 speed. That's a very handy trick if you're using YouTube. And let's see if we can hear that. So it kind of sounds like it's roughly the 15th fret of the E string. And now, here's something interesting. We're in a super big rush. I like to learn songs pretty much entirely by ear if I can, but to speed up the process, I do like using tabs. So I actually just Googled Learn to Fly by Foo Fighters tab.
Ladies and gentlemen, Foo Fighters.
Foo Fighters. Let's see if there's anything on the tab that shows this. Not really. So no big deal. I feel pretty confident about that 15th fret slide, but let's hear the other parts going on once the intro kicks in. Okay, so let's cross-reference with the tab. What we're seeing here is a riff is played along with the chords by another guitar, different endings to riff played throughout the song, right? Because that's a motif that comes back. So what this tab is telling me is we have a rhythm guitar part that's playing through those chords, B power chord, C sharp power chord, B power chord. And then we have that other part. I was kind of playing along when I was listening to the video. Sounded something like this. Yeah, the bend is just like a half step. And then what they're saying here, it seems like, is there's an alternate ending. And I think that might be at the end of the progression. So this sounds a little more musical. I'm gonna put it back to normal speed. Listen one more time through the intro to see if there's anything else we missed, but I feel pretty confident that I know those parts now. hear here is there's one part that seems to be staying on. Well, there's another something going down. It might be the other part. I don't know if that's the bass. Okay, so it sounds like there are two parts. One is going down like that. The other one's just staying on that B like that. So let's take a listen to the verse now. Let's see what's going on. Okay, so the first thing I'm hearing is that part, that lead part in the intro, kind of ends with. And it just rings out for the first part of the verse. The reason I threw on some overdrive there is because you can clearly hear there's some sort of overdrive on the guitar. But as soon as the verse starts, we hear another part coming in, sort of arpeggiating the chords. So I happen to notice that the tab has this written. So let's see if we agree with what they have. And how I'm going to check is I'm going to go back to the beginning of the verse. I'm going to put it in 0.75 speed. So it's not painfully slow, but it's slower. Okay. Let's see if this matches up with the song. Sorry, I went back too far. So it seems like there might be another guitar part subtly playing some extra colors on here. But again, I'm in a rush. The gig is in 2 minutes. Something crazy like that. That'll be good enough. That's what I would play throughout the verses. And then if I wanted to embellish it, and I didn't have time to learn it note for note, I would just take note of, you know, how I could potentially embellish the chords that I just learned. That's an example I came up with on the spot. I don't know if I like it, but you know, live shows are for trying stuff out. So let's back up the verse. I'm gonna throw on a chorus pedal because it's kind of a dreamy, you know, soundscapey sort of part. I'm gonna just try playing along, see what happens. Oh, it's major. Again. So I made the same mistake, because again, if you don't know the song super well, it's very likely you'll make a mistake. But the good news is, through that mistake, we heard very clearly, this isn't a minor chord, it should be a major chord. Like that. So if I wanted to play the full chord, I would obviously make sure to include that note to make it a major. If you really are not sure, just stick to something basic. You could even, let's say, simplify it even more if you still weren't feeling confident playing the part or embellishing or anything. I'm just looking at the tab and I'm just playing the bottom notes. And that would still sound really nice too, I think. So now, I think I have the verse and the intro down reasonably well. Of course, it helps that I have the tabs here with me. Let me try playing along, just see what happens. It might be terrible, but you know what? I kind of hope it is, because then I'll learn what not to do, and then I'll do better next time. Oops. is indicative of this style, usually super layered guitar. And again, this is why I would typically at this point have, you know, earbuds in, so I could try to separate the different parts, because the whole point is you have a whole bunch of parts together and it creates this sort of wall of sound. But let's see if we can discern what was going on in that chorus. I could sort of hear those kinds of power chords. So yeah, it seems like there are some subtler parts in the back. It seems like that dreamy guitar from the verse might still be present pretty low in the mix, but the most noticeable part was just kind of that power chord. And then that repeats a few times, and of course there's the make my way back home to fly high, and there's like a chord change. They sing it a little better than that, but let's see if we can figure that out just using our ears, because that's a great exercise, right? The more you can learn by ear, the better. What note is that? Not that. Did you guess G? So again, this is an example of just try a bunch of notes if you can't, you know, name it right off the bat. And let's say you didn't know it was a G and you played F sharp like I did the first time. You would just compare it to the original and see if it worked. Okay, so G clearly is the note. Awesome. Right, resolving then back to the B at the end, but let's say I literally had 2 seconds to learn that part before going on stage. I think you could totally rock just, you know, playing power chords on these chords here. G, A, and then you're back to B again. But let's listen again to see if there's any other, if there are any other details we could add. But feeling pretty all right with that so far. Again, it's hard to hear just through my speakers, but it sounds like these chords are kind of ringing out. The first one just sounds like a G major. The next one, it's kind of hard to make out, but it's something kind of dreamy, so I'm just gonna rock something like this, because that kind of has a bit of a dreamy quality to it. I'm in a rush, no time to plug in my headphones and figure out more. This will do for now. Now we're back to the intro. Definitely goes down there. Stays here. Now we're back to the verse. So just by listening to that second verse, I could totally hear another guitar part over top of the dreamy part we've already been playing, you know, layering it, adding more color. I'm sure there's a verse and a solo and all of that to work on, but again, no time. We have a time crunch right now. I think this would probably get the job done. And again, in an ideal situation, I would have my headphones out. I would do pretty much all of it by ear. But I think, you know, cross-referencing with the tab, even if you barely use the tab at all, can just give you a pretty good idea of where to at least start. Like, okay, we're kind of in this area of the neck. Cool, go from there. And it'll make it a lot easier to find what parts of the tab are not correct. Because I think the more you use your ear, the more you realize that, you know, a lot of resources out there are awesome and super helpful, but might not be 100% correct. So they always say, if you want something done right, do it yourself. And the most important part of that is actually just developing your ear in general, right? It's not about other people's mistakes. Other people are wonderful, and they're all on their own journey. It's not to judge, but it's just for you as a player. Develop your ear, because then you'll literally be able to play any song you want, even if there are no tabs or chords available online. And then you're not really limited by anything at that point, right? Which is great. So at this point, we kind of got the rhythm and lead part down for the intro that kind of repeats throughout the song. We have a pretty good idea of how to tackle the verse. The chorus, we kind of figured out what chords we'd need to get through that. And I'd feel pretty confident playing through the first part of the song. In a jam situation, if let's say we got to the bridge in the solo section and no one had told me the chords, I would make sure to tap the other guitar player or bass player on the shoulder before we started and say, hey, would you mind facing me, you know, while we're playing? And then you could kind of just mirror what they're doing as best you can. Maybe turn down a little bit. You know, that could be a great way to deal with the situation. But again, the more you put yourself in situations like this, the better you're going to get. And the more you're going to be able to just figure things out by hearing them. And that's obviously a great skill as a musician. Thanks for joining me on this journey today. I'm going to try to play through what we have so far, just kind of fake my way through. And I hope you learned a little something about how you can tackle this process yourself.
Is it on Foo or Fighters? And I said, I think it's on Fighters. He's like, that's what I thought.
You know. I'm sorry.